Hey everybody, it's Ella Tai and we are back here with another tutorial. So to start, I'm using the Aveeno Clear Complexion Moisturizer. So let's just rub that all over our face. Now I'm going to go do my eyebrows off camera. I just used a LA Girl Pro Concealer in the shade Toffee. I used the Anastasia Beverly Hills Perfect Brow Pencil in the color Dark Brown. As you guys can see, I'm using a fluffy concealer brush to blend it out. And to set that concealer, I'm using banana powder. I'm just pressing that all on the lid. So after we get that done, we're going to get into this eyes. So we're using the Morphe 12P palette. We're using the M511 brush and the orange shade in the palette. So as you guys can see, I'm going back and forth in circular motions. When it comes to doing a smoky eye, it's all about blending and product placement. You want a gradient effect of color. So now we're going right back into that palette and we're using the red eyeshadow in the 12P palette with a smaller blending brush. This is a Sigma E40 brush. And we're kind of like, you know, getting in that crease. Not really, but like, you know, around about it. So we're doing the other eye now. And now we're going to go into my self-made Anastasia Beverly Hills palette. We're using a Real Techniques blending brush and we're using the shade Seinna to kind of blend on the lid. As you guys can see, as I'm blending, the brushes are getting smaller. So now we went back into that palette and we're using the shade Beauty Mark from Anastasia Beverly Hills. And now I'm really getting into that crease to get that gradient effect of color. Now I'm using my MAC self-made palette. I'm using the color I'm Into It. And now I'm going back and kind of retouching the orange because I want that gradient effect to be there. So now I'm just going to tap that excess burgundy onto my lid to make sure we have that nice smoked out effect. Now to prime our skin, we're using the Nivea Post Shave Balm. And as you guys can see, I'm not rubbing it into the skin. I'm pressing it with the tips of my fingers and I just press that all into my skin. I am using a new foundation now, you guys. This is the Burberry Fresh Glow foundation in the shade 005, I think it is, but the color is a deep brown. And I'm using a beauty blender and I'm basically pouncing or bouncing that into my skin just so, you know, we can have that nice flawless airbrushed coverage. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna highlight and contour. I'm using the LA Girl Pro Concealers in the shade Chestnut and Toffee. I'm using a flat concealer brush and as you guys can see, the placement is everything when it comes to highlighting and contouring. I want my nose to be defined. I want my under eye to be really popping. And as you guys can see, I bring that concealer to the top of my lip because I want a more chiseled face. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna create an exclamation point on my nose and kind of fan out the excess concealer and put some concealer on my chin. Now we're going back in with another beauty blender and we're going to pounce that all into our skin. It is all about blending. You want to make sure you are blending to the best of your ability. So I'm just pressing everything into the skin. If you guys wonder why I'm speaking, I was actually on Instagram Live while I was filming this tutorial. So now I'm blending all of that out, pressing it into the skin. I'm not rubbing. So now we're going to contour. I'm using my contour stick or my concealer stick from Black Radiance. And I'm placing that right underneath my chin. I'm placing that underneath my cheekbone. I'm placing it on the perimeter of my chin. I'm placing it on my jawline, not my chin, my jawline. And I'm going to do my forehead and I did my nose off camera. So this is going to give you more of an angular, more structured face. I will always use cream contour to contour my face because me personally, I feel like it gives me that dimension that I'm looking for. So now that we are about to blend all of this out, I don't know why I didn't put the footage in there. I don't know what I was thinking, but I blended all of that out. But the main thing a lot of people keep asking me is how do I blend my nose contour? So what I do is I use a fluffy shadow brush and I literally just, like, you know, blend that product back and forth until it is not noticeable anymore. And I always bring the nose contour under my eyebrows just so it gives my nose more structure and shape and so it looks more defined and chiseled. So I really think this is a great technique to use whenever you're learning how to contour your nose. So I set my face already with Ben Nye banana powder and Black Opal's setting powder in the shade medium. Now I'm going to smoke out the bottom waterline. I'm going back into that 12P palette and I use that orange shade. Now we're going back in with a smaller eyeshadow brush and we're using that red shade to really, like, you know, define out our eye color. Now I am wiping off all of the excess product with this really big fluffy brush. I don't even know the name of this brush, but it is one of my favorites. I think I like to use it because it gets all the excess baking powder off of my skin. So the next thing we're gonna do now is we're gonna warm up our face. So I'm gonna go into my Anastasia Beverly Hills contour palette, tan to deep, and I'm using a small fluffy angled brush to really carve out those cheeks. And if you guys caught in the beginning, the top palette is what I used on my eyes earlier. I also use eyeshadows to kind of carve out my face a little bit. As you can see, I'm using Seinna Beauty Mark and the dark brown shade from the Anastasia Beverly Hills contour palette, and I'm bringing it up toward my face. I'm not bringing it down, I'm blending up. I want you guys to really pay attention to that. So after I do all of this, the next thing we're gonna do once I'm done warming up my face, because I guess I didn't know this footage was this long. I had no idea it was this long. So we are still contouring, we are still contouring, we are still contouring. We are making sure that this face is chiseled and defined and popping and on fleek and amazing. Okay, Ty, all right. Let them know what you do on the weekends, okay. All right, yes, yes, blend that out. But this is a really crucial step, you guys. This is extremely crucial. You wanna make sure that you're brown. So now what I'm doing is I'm using the Beauty Bakery's liquid lip in the color Midnight Truffle, and I'm mixing it with the Nicka K liquid lip in the color Wineberry. Yes, I overline my lips because I like a prominent lip line. I know I have full lips. Thank God I have full lips, and I'm not trying to make my lips any bigger. I just like definition whenever I do my makeup. So I'm lining my lips with this liquid lipstick, this black liquid lipstick. And of course, you guys know I'm gonna have to go back up and clean it up because I am messy as fuck when it comes to doing lipsticks. I'm really messy. So now that we have that lip line together, hurry up, girl, get your life. Now we're gonna put the Wineberry on top. And as you guys can see, that creates that beautiful burgundy liquid lip that I love so much. The reason why I didn't make this color because I couldn't find it. Yeah, that was really messy. So what I did, you guys, off camera was I put on some Lash Primer from L'Oreal, the Voluminous Lash Primer. It was amazing. And then I'm like, you know, doing my bottom lash line. But you guys always know I put lashes on. So I'll be right back. And hello, it's me. Yes. Ooh. How are you? Thank you guys so much for watching. Please comment, rate, and subscribe. Tell your friends to subscribe. I genuinely appreciate you guys stopping by. I hope you guys have a wonderful day. Stay tuned for my next video. And bye, everybody.